How you guys doing? Chris Ignato here, and you are watching Nature Now, your guide to nature and adventure. So, have you ever sat yourself down next to a tree trunk, only to notice little bits of lichen or the bark itself walking about? Well, let's have a closer look, shall we? If you've ever noticed little pieces of lichen walking about on a tree trunk, your eyes are not playing tricks on you. You have found none other than the debris-carrying lacewing larva, also known as the junk bug. These insects are the larva or immature stage of the elegant lacewing. Being carnivores, they camouflage themselves up and hunt among the trunks of trees and upon bushes and plants by sweeping their heads back and forth as they search for food. Their main food items are aphids and leaf scales, and as you might know, those insects are often guarded by ants who tend to them like shepherds. Periodically, they'll take little bits of lichen and other debris and stick it upon their backs. They do this to disguise themselves. Sometimes, they even take the hollow corpses of their discarded meals and stick them there also. Imagine if mammals did that. Those dead remains of their prey help camouflage them, and more importantly, they cover up their scent and make them smell just like the flock, disguising them from the ants. Well, that gives a new meaning to the Walking Dead now, doesn't it? Of course, it also protects them from predators. It's kind of fun to watch them adorn themselves. They just grab that debris or the discarded remains of their last meal and stick it on their back. Now, here's a view from the underside of one I placed on a piece of glass. And as you can tell from this view, there's definitely an immature lacewing underneath all that debris. These creatures look rather ferocious for being so small, don't they? I'm sure you can guess those formidable mandibles are for a grim purpose, snatching up and devouring their prey. Those mandibles are hollow and used by sweeping their heads back and forth. Once they happen across a prey item, aphids, leaf scales, etc., they'll quickly grab hold of them and inject powerful enzymes into their bodies. Within 90 seconds, the insides are totally dissolved, and the larva will begin to suck out the insides of the unfortunate insect. Here is a little piece of lichen, moving on. And here, you can see what I mean by walking about with their head sweeping back and forth. Those mandibles sticking out from the underside are a dead giveaway. No pun intended. Well, actually, yeah, it is intended. I'm not sure why, but I've noticed their number increase the last couple of years alongside the spotted lanternflies. Trees that have a lot of spotted lanternflies on them seem to have more of these lacewing larvae also. I'm not really sure what the connection is yet. Now, if you actually want to find these yourself, they're probably all around you and you just don't know it. Try finding trees like this that have the moss and lichen growing on them, or better yet, find spots with a lot of aphids. I'm sure you'll find immature lacewings at some point. Happy hunting. Well, there you have it. Those little monsters are kind of amazing, aren't they? In the future, I'll try to have a video with them actually hunting and feeding, but until then, you'll just have to be patient. So, thanks a lot for watching, guys. Once again, I'm Chris Ignato, signing out.
Thanks a lot for watching, and remember, if you like this video, be sure to check out this video over here that YouTube has selected specifically for you based on your watch time. And don't forget to hit that subscribe button, but you gotta click the bell icon, because if you don't, YouTube will never let you know when a new video of mine comes out. And remember, passion inspires spirit.